Sorry. This is the topic of the lecture. We're gonna see what is events, what's a sync API, and why everybody is talking about this again. So first of all, I am Ana Borges. I am from Brazil. I work with Syncidia. Anyone here know about Syncidia? I need to see more hands because I talked with you yesterday. You're lying to me. Yeah. So I am a cat person. So these are my two babies. And yes, Ana Borges is my professional name, and Paula Simichelli is my another name. So this is my social media, if anyone wanna know. And let's see a little more about Syncidia. Syncidia is a pure play API. Everything we do is about APIs. We have an API platform for you work with your API governance, with reports, analytics. Is very cool. We have a consulting service for help your company how to use the better way of APIs. We want that you make some cool things for your business. We are presenting here in Europe and Latam. We have more than 100 customers. We do the APX. Is one of the largest events of focus on API on the world. And we have some recognitions from Gartner, like Visionaries, and we are recognized for Forrester for our services in consulting. So let's talk about events. This guy, I don't know him, do you know him? It's probably important because everything he says we do. So they say that by 2020, events are be most than 80% of your company. But why? Because events are more recognized more quickly, and you don't need to wait for the processing for keep doing stuff. So, but what is events? So let's talk about a little bit. An event is everything we do is like, this API day is a kind of event. I'm speaking with you is an event. But when we work with one event-driven architecture, we don't want to know about all the events, just the events that have meaningful for our company. This is the business event. And what could be this business event? For example, an order of a customer, a product change, a bank payment. This has meaningful for my company. And what is EDA? The EDA wants to do the production, detection, and reaction of the events. So it's based on that. Okay, but why I work with event-driven architecture? Because I can be more resilient. I can do the scalable with one server and another I don't need to touch. So it's very interesting. And let's talk first about the topology of the event. Of the EDA. We have these three guys. We have the event generator, we have the mediator, broker, and the consumers. The event generator is like your customer service. Then when your customer changes some information, you send an event for your mediator or broker and say, notify the persons that are interested on this notification. The events consumers or processor are the system that want to know about your event. It's like, for example, on an insurance scenario, quotation service. When a customer changes the address, we need to know if the policy of the insurance will change, because this change for the price they will pay for the policy. And the mediator or broker are the intermediary. In this guy, we don't know a little bit more because the mediator is when I need to use some logical thing about inside on my events, and the broker is when I did just pass the information. So this is the mediator. I have a guy in the middle that we're gonna see logical stuff on your events. So, for example, of this insurance scenario. My customer changed the address, so the customer service will send the information on the database and send the notification, follow your life. Then I'm gonna send notification for the Kiwi, and the event may it's very difficult. Speak another language. The event mediator are responsible for see, okay, this is the first step of the event. So the first step for this kind of event, I go to quotation service and say, okay, this information, you do whatever you want to do with this guy. So the quotation service will make the quotation again and see, okay, this guy need to pay more for his insurance premium because he's living like a dangerous place right now. So he will return the message for the mediator, and the mediator will know, okay, this message already passed for the quotation service, now I need to send that message for notification service. So the mediator send notification for notification service, and notification service send an email, for example, for the guy has moved, the guy who has moved. If, for example, the quotation service was not, he's not gonna change the price of your insurance. So the quotation service will return the notification from mediator, and mediator will know, okay, I don't need to send nothing for the notification service. So he know a logical, a little bit about logical of your business, for he can do the orchestration stuff. We can implement that like Apache Kafka. Spring. This is Spring. Kafka is broken, sorry. And these guys, quotation service and notification service, they need to work alone. They don't need to know nothing. For example, the quotation service cannot depend on notification service. And the broker is when I don't need to have any logical stuff. So the customer will change the address, and the customer says, okay, I will change it in my database, and I will send a notification for the Kiwi, and the quotation service will be listening to the Kiwi, will be taking the message, do all the job, and then, okay, this guy needs to pay more. So I send a notification for the notification Kiwi, and if, okay, they don't need, I don't, we'll put anything on the Kiwi. So this Kiwi, for example, can be used for another systems. They don't need to be used only for the quotation service. A notification can be the Kiwi for notification service. So if I want anything on my company be notified for anyone, I can send the notification, I can send something for here, okay? So in this guy, we don't have any logical business. Okay, let's see a little about the principles of this architecture. We need reports current evently, so if anything happens that's important for me, I need notify in the right time. It's a notification, I not can send a message, say what to do, I need to say this change and done. If I receive something, if I am a processor or a consumer and I receive something, I need the answer right now. It's like, okay, I don't know this, I don't wanna do nothing with this, so I send a message to the trash, but this is my answer for the thing. I need to know something with the message that came. Communication flow only in one direction, so the producer will send the message for consumers and just that way. And the producer will follow your life, he not be waiting about the message come back, so it's only in that way. And it's command free. I just say, customer X changed the address. I do not say, okay, quotation services, customer X change their data, you need to do that, that, and that. Because it's more easy for us adding new consumers for my Kiwis when I don't have this type of commands. I need to say something's changing. You know what to do with this information. And like your architecture, you have some standards. I'm talking too fast, guys. No, do you understand what I'm saying? My English is not so woohoo, but if you don't understand anything, you can raise your hand and say, please.
Okay.
Yeah, cool. Yeah. So the standards. Go team. We have three principal standards for EDA. These three here, we're going to see them a little bit more. So event notification is like when something's changed, I will have the same example. No, it's another example. Think with me with example, please. We have a store of sneakers that, and I have my bank service. This, when I'm moving, I was moving a few months ago, I change all my address in all the stores that I buy clothes, sneakers, but I not change anything on the bank account. So my letters from the bank came on the old address, and my sneakers are coming on my right address. So think with me in a partnership with the company of sneakers and the bank company, when the bank company can get information from the store of sneakers. It's a cool thing. We know the general layer protection of the data, need to be concerned about that, but in a cool world, that's gonna happen. So in a scenario with the notification, we're gonna be like this. Oh, the customer changed the address. So I will store the information on my database and send a notification for my event broken, for example. And I have these two guys are interested on my notification. So banking service is going to see, oh, this customer X is mine. I need to see where they go. So I need to do a get for my customer services forget the information, because the notification service only say customer X changed their data, product Y changed the information of pricing. It's just that. So if you wanna know more about the changing, you need to know to the source of the change for you see. This guy, like pros, we have uncoupled. We remove the accomplishment of the receiving and sender. But depends on implementation, we can do overload the producer. Because if I have 10 people here interested on the message, they go all the same time to the customer service, forget information. So we need to be concerned about that. Okay? You are not so happy face, so I think you're not understanding. So event carried state transfer. It's like with the same example, we have the address change with the customer service. We put the information in the database, but the message this time will like the customer's X update their data for to zip code 123. We say what change. And this, the bank service, for example, if they want them, they want the information, he can store in your own database. And he don't need to come to me for get this information. So with this, we gain more resilience, because if, for example, I want more information about a customer X, I don't need to wait for the customer service can be up again if it was down when I called the first time. I can go to my database and get the information. If you may have seen, I don't have the overload of the customer service anymore. But we have a little counts. It's like we have replication of information, because all the information gonna be there. How is the information right? So we need to be very careful about this. And event sourcing. Everybody here, I believe, work with event source. It's like GitHub. Do you know GitHub? Yeah, it's like an event source. So what's the event sourcing? Event source is when you store all the changes of your system, because it's like this guy. I have some address change, And I send for my event data sourcing. I say, okay, customer X update the zip code to 123. With this information, I can rebuild my system in any time that I want, foresee how was your functionality on certain event. We gain a little more about audit and debugging. Okay, so it's like we have with GitHub, okay? It's a cool example of event sourcing. I can see what is there, and for example, I know who did something, who broke my code, so it's very interesting, but we have a little cons when we work with event sourcing. It's not very familiar. Now we had started more people have implemented this pattern, but not so much yet. And you need to know what you're gonna put on event data sourcing. You cannot put everything that comes to your system because your data source will be huge. So you need to choose what you wanna put on your data sourcing. Okay. So what's a sync API? Everybody's talking about the sync API. What is it? It's a specification. It's for event-driven, what is for our microservices, Swagger, or Open API. So it's focused on the application and the channels that we use for communicated. So when you have a new consumer now for your Kiwi, you don't need to send a PDF huge, say, okay, you need to do this, this, this. You can send the other documentation like Swagger, yeah. You can look at that, you can consume it that way. So we have definition of the event payload, the channel name, the application transports, the header, the protocol. It's very cool. Okay, take a picture. Sorry. No? No? Okay, thank you.
Wait.
Ah! Okay, go, run fast. Here. So this is a structure. It's very like we see on Vincenzo talk. We have the part of the information, the servers. We can define our channels. If for every channel, we can say the item, the operation, what's the type of, what's the payload you need to send to me. It's very interesting because until this times we need to send, okay, is MQTT, I believe. It's a pub sub, you need to send this board, this example. So it's very easy to use right now. And this is like we define, for example, a server. We have the host, what the port, what's the technology you are using, like MQTT. For the security, we use API key, for example, what the follow we're gonna use. And this is how you define operation. We have, okay, this is like our REST operation. So I have this action with ID, I wanna turn off. This is the payload of the information. So it becomes very easy to work with events. So, okay, I'm talk. What's the pros and cons on my point of view, because né, it's a pros. We reduce the coupling. We don't need more monolithic that I need to call every time and everything. It's like my microservices. Okay, I have now the structure of microservices, but I still need to go one microservice and another and another and another, and I be depending on this for working. I work with asynchronous operation, so it's more it's more hard to get wrong. It's easy to add new customers because one time I have just comments on my Kiwi. I don't need to, for example, change something in my code for adding new customers. And we have the most cool thing is high scalable. So if I want to scale just one component, I can scale just this component without need to scale everything. And a little cons. May lead to lose information because when I send a message to broker and has no one here in the broker, I don't know if anyone get the message. So if it has no one listening, the message that I send will be lost. We will lose. It can add more complexity if poorly implemented, but I believe you can. You can the same opinion with me is anything that you implemented wrong, it's very awful later. And is a challenge for data and flow governance because, okay, the data came until here, I send the subscribers, and now. For where the message goes, I need to be there very with mapping for I can flow, and now. So you need to understand you need, first of all, because if you have the information and maybe a synchronous thing is cool for you. You work with microservices, with a REST template, and that's cool, that's work for you. But if not, you need to choose the best architecture. So, okay, I have a story, I see that EDA is gonna help me. That's the next step. Right now, you need to choose the partner. So you can send all the notifications. Oh no, you wanna work with the current state because it's memorial type of business. And then you need to choose the tool that best meets for you. We have a lot of tools on the market. And I wanna talk to you. We have also a solution for events. It's our new product. We work with events, so we do push for subscribers. We work a lot in security stuff. It's very important for us. We do the retry information for the subscribers because if it's not available, we try again and again until he's gone to get the message. And it's very safety because we are very concerned about this. Okay? And hands-on because you need to try the solutions for you know what to use. And Tencija had a booth right down there. You can go talk to us more about the solution. So that is it. Here's a guide reference for API design. And if you have any doubts, and this is my contacts if you wanna know. We have time for questions.
3 minutes.
Hi, question guys.
So 3 minutes for questions. Anybody? That was. Was it super clear?
Yeah, I don't think so.
I got a question. So you mentioned governance of events. What is, in your opinion, the best solution for to solve this problem, the problem with the governance, if you have an opinion at all? I mean, don't feel forced.
Oh my God. I think you need to know all your subscribers, and you need, this is one thing that we do on Event Hub. We have all mapping your consumers, so you know where your data are going to. This is a part that you can do for help the governance.
That's it. Nobody has any more.
Anybody? Okay, so thanks. Thank you, Anna.